iPhone 7 leaked metal casing shows us that speakers are gonna be a big deal. If there's any doubt over the final name of the future Galaxy Note, we've got some news. And Google seems to be in need of building its own smartphone after all. I'm Jaime Rivera, and the problem with recording in the tropics is that it's horribly hot in the day, and then right now it's raining. This is Pocket Out Daily. The official news today again begin with deals, and with the 32GB Nexus 5X, I think we dedicated at least 3 or 4 days of deals for this particular smartphone, and it just keeps getting less and less expensive. Right now, it's for $240 on eBay. I know, don't even think about it, just hit the link in the description. Now, for those of you that still have doubts over the final name of the Galaxy Note, well, famous tipster Evan Blass just came on record and confirmed that there is rendered text directly from Samsung that says Galaxy Note 7. And this makes a lot of sense. Obviously, it's the Galaxy S7 year. There's always been that confusion, and well, not necessarily confusion, but just that disparity over numbers every year. So it would just make sense to bring everything on par, not just with the Galaxy S, but also with the number of the iPhone that's coming a little later, right? And since we're speaking iPhone, we've got some very interesting metal case leaks of what we expect to be the iPhone 7, revealing 2 very interesting things. Number one, the camera hole, which is huge. Means we probably get an update there. But the other very interesting change is the speaker grills at the bottom. We've been debating if it's just gonna be 1 speaker, if it's gonna be 4 speakers. This metal casing kind of reveals only 2 at the bottom. And we are just hoping that this is not just a design thing, that we actually get stereo speakers on this thing that mimic what we get on the iPad Pro lineup, which is amazing. Now let's move the spotlight over to Huawei. There has been much speculation over the company moving away from Android. For reasons not really mentioned, we do know that Huawei is the company that's been doing a ton of its own stuff, starting with processors. And we heard some rumors that it might build its own operating system, but according to the company's CEO, the company will remain using Android going forward, so long as the operating system is pretty much free, meaning so much that it's open source, they could do whatever they want with it, because that's really the beauty of Android. You can pretty much do whatever you want, so long as you're an OEM, right? And finally, the very hot news today have to do with Google, Alphabet, and the probability of a smartphone that's not a Nexus. Apparently, the Nexus lineup will continue, but it seems that there is an Alphabet subsidiary that will be building a smartphone for Google. And the only company that we can really think of is the one that's in charge of Project Aura, which is great. We're not necessarily sure if this phone will be the Project Aura phone, but it seems that the company wants to build its own smartphone and have it compete with the Nexus, it seems, which is rather weird, but it leads me to the question of today. Do you think that there is a need for another Google phone out there? In my case, it would make sense for there to be a Google phone for emerging markets. It would be cool to have the Google phone be the Project Aura phone. But for it to compete with the Nexus, I don't know. Leave us a comment down below. We'd love to know your opinion. Friends, you know the way it goes. If you want to get the news earlier before the video is filmed, follow us on PocketNow.com and hit that subscribe button down below for more videos like this one. You can also catch our videos on Vessel, vessel.com/PocketNow, and follow me on Twitter, Jaime_Rivera, or on Instagram at Jaime Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.